Hi, welcome back to Rathaus Academy. I hope you have done this. Now, why again I'm showing you this? Because I want some more improvement in this. What can be the improvements over here? Like this boat is moving on its own. There is no movement in the hand of the boatman and the stick also is not moving. So I want those movements. Okay, I want these movements over here. As you know that if you want any movement, then each movement, whatever the part is moving, that should be on a different layer. So we need to create two different layers, one for the hand and one for the stick and another one for the boat. So we have to have three layers in which each of them are moving in a different position. I'll show you how. For that, I need to delete my boat because this boat is having three things which are moving and they are moving in the same position. There is no separate movement. So I have to delete them and I have to keep each and every moving part on a different layer. Delete boat layer and I'm also deleting this right layer. After that, insert a new layer, name it as boat again. But this time, this without the hand, because both this hand is going to be on a different layer. Select your first frame, take your brush and make your boat here. This is the boatman, cap, and fill the color with the bucket tool. Now again you need the shadow, so what you will do, you will click on the first frame and then copy it and paste it. Move it with the help of your selection tool and then flip vertical. Adjust the position. If you want to change the color, change it now because it is selected. And we take a different color, this one. After that, insert a keyframe at 40th frame and create motion tool. Change the position at 40th frame. It's going to be here. Okay, and after that, I want the first frame, I'm making the size smaller. With the help of transform tool, you can make it smaller like this, and in the last frame let it be like this and a little bit wider. Right now again you need the zigzag path because it is moving straight. I want the zigzag path, the wavy motion. Right, for that what I have done in the last video, I have added the motion guide. So right click and add motion guide. Select the first cell and the first layer, first frame, and with the help of the pencil, take a color. Let me take this color so that it is visible. And here I am creating a wavy path for my boat. Right, now take on the first frame and with the help of the selection tool, move it to the first point and similarly click on the last frame and adjust its position for the last. Let me check it now. It's not moving. Let's check this again. It's moving. Control enter. The stick as well as the hand of that man. Again create a new layer and name it as the stick that helps to sail the boat. So let me name as stick. and draw your stick. It should be longer, right? So let me draw it like this, okay? Is it closer? Too closer? Is it fine now? So after that, insert again a keyframe at 40th frame and then move this in, also do that, create motion tween and change the position of your stick to the last frame. Now click on the last frame and do that tint. I haven't done it, you also have to do it. Similarly for the stick, you will say tint. For the stick, you will say color tint and it will change the color. Again, test this, control enter. Okay, the color has been changed. Now we have to show the movement of the stick. So click on the first keyframe, insert a keyframe at the frame, then on 10th frame, 15th, 20th, 25th, 30, 35. Now because I have inserted so many keyframes, so in each and every frame the position should be different, right? This is the position of the stick in the first frame. Now it has to be changed in the fifth frame, so click on your free transform tool and rotate it like this. Okay, now again it should be like this, and here again I have to rotate. Similarly in the 20th frame again I have to rotate this. You can increase the size if you want. This again has to be rotated. Increase the size. And again it's fine. Now test this, control enter. Yes, isn't the stick is moving. Now we have to show the hand as well, so we need to create a new layer for the hand. Name it as hand. You need to move the hand again. First of all, create motion tween and adjust the position in the last keyframe. That is 40th frame. Move it here. Let me make it bigger so that I can move it. It's too big, right? Okay. With the help of the arrow keys you can move it and adjust. Okay, again select this one, click on your selection tool and say tint. It has changed the color. Now again you have to insert the keyframe again at 5th, 10th, 15th, 20th, 25th, 30th and 35th frame. So do that. that was the position in the first frame. With the help of selection tool, you can adjust it again. Right, now this is the position in the second one. So I need to rotate, make it down, and let me shift it down. Now the hand is over here, which you can see that the transform tool is there. Let me move it up and make it like this. Move it like this. Now again, over here it's too big. With the help of the arrow keys, you can move it back, up and down. Again, it has been come down, so move it here, make it little like this, and switch. With the help of the arrow key, you can do this. That is something better, but the only thing is that you have to keep the patience, and whatever the part you want to move, that has to be on a separate layer, because each moving part is moving separately. Thank you and have a nice day. And if you have any comment, if you have any problem, if you have any suggestion, please give me your comments in the comment box, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Click on the bell icon for getting the latest updates and latest new things I create myself on this channel. Have a nice day.